Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone. Welcome back to Allah Loves. So last time we talked about this concept of loving someone else for Allah's sake. And a lot of times, unfortunately, we immediately expand that and extend it to others outside of our households, but we forget the people that are inside of our households. And there is no person that you should think of more when you hear those ahadith than your mother. Because the Prophet, peace be upon him, when a man asked him, "To whom should I give my honor and kindness to?" The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Your mother." Then he said, "Who?" He said, "Then your mother." Then he said, "Who?" He said, "Then your mother." He said, "Then who?" He said, "Then your father." So we know that Allah has preferred the mother in a very special way, that the Prophet, peace be upon him, sent a companion back to his mother and said, "Paradise lies at her feet." That Allah has put the obedience to the parents in the Quran with obedience to him, that you worship him and obey him, and that you show a similar level of kindness and love to your parents without, of course, worshiping them or preferring them over the Creator. But he included them. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. He included them by saying that your Lord has judged that you worship none other but him and that you show only excellence to your parents. So where's this concept that Allah loves your mother? And I have to give this qualifier that this does not mean tolerating injustice or oppression or harm. These are things that are outside of the scope of the default and need to be dealt with as exceptional cases. But in general, the status of the mother and this concept of earning the love of Allah by showing love to your mother, there are two narrations that I want to share with you today. One of them from the Prophet, peace be upon him. The other one from Abdullah bin Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, the cousin of the Prophet, peace be upon him. The Prophet, peace be upon him, had a man who approached him and said to the Prophet, peace be upon him, that I committed a major sin. Halli tawbah, is there any way for me to repent to Allah? The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Do you have a mother? Is your mother alive?" And the man said, "No." Look at the follow-up question of the Prophet, peace be upon him. He said, "Well, does your mother have a sister? Do you have an aunt that's alive? A maternal aunt that's alive?" The man said, "Yes." The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Then go be good to her. Show her some ihsan, show her some excellence and some love, and hope for Allah's mercy in the process of that." So it wasn't even, you know, after the mother, the Prophet, peace be upon him, jumped far out. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Well, is there an aunt?" And of course, in those societies, and in many societies today, the khala, the aunt, particularly the maternal aunt, really plays a motherly role in a person's life. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, mentioned al-khala, the maternal aunt, bimanzilatil umm, that she has the station of the mother. So she's the number two when it comes to that honor and that love. But again, that idea of, you know, you committed a major sin between you and Allah, well, go ahead and go to your mother and show her goodness and see if that's a way of opening that door of pleasure with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The narration from Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu is a very profound one. A man came to Ibn Abbas and he was guilty of murder. So he confessed to Abdullah bin Abbas that he killed someone, that he became jealous and he killed someone. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu responded to him, "Ummuka hayy, is your mother alive?" Now, this is separate, by the way, from any legal proceedings and anything that would take place in the capacity of retribution. He's worried about his akhirah, he's worried about his hereafter. Is there any chance of me to have forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And that's what he came to Ibn Abbas asking. And Ibn Abbas says to him, "Is your mother alive?" And the man said, "No." Ibn Abbas said to him, "Well, just go and seek Allah's forgiveness sincerely and hope in his mercy." So he gave him a generic answer after asking him specifically, "Is your mother alive?" So the students of Ibn Abbas, the scholar of this ummah, they asked him, they said, "You know, it's interesting. Why did you ask him about his mother? His mother wasn't even in the equation. He killed somebody. He's worried if he's going to be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he still has a chance at Allah's mercy." And that's what you asked him. Ibn Abbas said, he said, "Wallahi, I don't know. I swear by Allah that I don't know of an action more beloved to Allah than serving your mother. I cannot think of an action that Allah loves more than showing kindness and obedience to one's mother." SubhanAllah. These are things that are so easy to us. They're so accessible to us. And if your mother is still alive, then make sure that you make use of that. And Zainul Abideen, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that if one gate has closed, then go to the other gate. Then please your father. Then show that love to your father and that obedience to your father as well. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, of course mentioned that the rida, that the pleasure of the father is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so our parents are truly a gate to paradise, serving them, showing kindness to them, showing love to them, especially as they become older in age, showing patience with them as a result. These are all things we seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is no person and no two people that you can love for Allah more than your parents. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be pleased with us, to let our parents be pleased with us, and to join us all, our parents, our spouses, children, brothers, sisters, aunts and uncles, and everyone else. We ask Allah to join us in the highest level of Jannat al-Firdaus. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.